never be demeaned. His deputy will never be harassed. His deputy will never be persecuted. His deputy will never be disrespected. And his deputy will be facilitated to work and work well. For the first year, that happened. And I'm grateful to him because he did not allow anybody to disrespect me. He did not allow anybody to interfere with my work. But the second year, I must tell you, that is happening. You know, cabinet ministers have been abusing the deputy president. Just the way it was happening during the time of Uhuru Kenyatta. You remember Tobiko called President William Ruto a clerk. Matiang'i wrote him a message that called him an idiot. And people disrespected him. People were intimidated. People were harassed. And President William Ruto made a commitment to the people of Kenya that if he is elected president, it will never happen that his deputy will be disrespected. Today, the deputy president is abused by people hugging on his car, and the president is quiet. Cabinet ministers have been abusing the deputy president. The president is quiet. The president has given many promises to the people of Kenya. Some of them he has not been able to fulfill them because of the difficult economic situations that we are in, and it's understandable. But there's one promise he gave to the people of Kenya that requires no finance. It requires nothing. It requires him to be a gentleman and keep that promise. The promise he gave the people of Kenya, that under his presidency, his deputy will not be abused, his deputy will not be disrespected, his deputy will not be intimidated, his deputy will not be persecuted, his deputy will not be harassed. That, I think, the president, my boss, owes that to the people of Kenya to honor that promise so that Kenyans can trust him and he can win the trust of the people of Kenya, because this is something within his purview. He requires no funding, he requires no financing, he requires no urging. It's a commitment he gave. And he also gave it to me,
right,
with my wife and my children. When he asked me to be his running mate, I sat with him and my wife and my children, and we asked him, we have seen what you have gone through. If our father becomes your deputy, will he be taken through what you are taken through? And he gave us as a family a very firm commitment that that will never happen. I'm asking President William Ruto, my boss, please keep your promise to the people of Kenya. Stop those people who are abusing your deputy. Stop those ministers who are demeaning your deputy. Don't allow the criminal justice system to harass and intimidate your deputy the way you are intimidated. If you cannot keep the other promises to the people of Kenya, at least this one is a very simple promise. Be a good man. Be a good Christian. Keep that promise, President William Ruto, because that is a commitment you give to the people of Kenya, and you gave me that promise in front of my wife and children that you will never allow anybody to demean me, to disrespect me, to harass me, to persecute me, to intimidate me, to coerce me. That is a commitment that you gave. I ask you, Mr. President, keep that commitment.
Are you frustrated?
I'm not. I am, let me tell you, son, you don't know me. Many people don't understand Rigathi Gachagua. Rigathi Gachagua is a seasoned leader who has seen many ups and downs. I underwent hell in the last administration to support President William Ruto. Cases were fabricated against me for studying with President William Ruto. My wealth was confiscated for studying with William Ruto. But I'm a very, very, very principled man. I stood with him to the last man. I never expected this to happen. You know, my family is devastated. You know, that this can be happening to their father. A man who went out of his way to start with President William Ruto and make sure he's elected president and took the flag for it. And I say, even if there is a jinx around this position, at least President William Ruto was allowed to do his work for 5 years without interruption, without harassment, for 5 years. I've only done 1 year. And what is happening to me is worse than what happened to President William Ruto. I asked President William Ruto, please allow me to work. Allow me to work for the remaining 3 years. Let me serve the people of Kenya.
Okay.
Let me serve the people of Kenya and keep your promise. Keep your promise, Mr. President, so that you can win the trust of the people of Kenya as an honest person, as a person who keeps his promise. What is happening is not right. It doesn't augur well, and it has, to a great extent, eroded the trust of the people of Kenya in your leadership. Please, Mr. President, I am here willing to work, to serve you with the dedication, to serve the people of Kenya, to support you the way I've always done, to undertake whatever responsibilities that you assign me. But let the insults in your presence stop. Let people not hold night meetings. Let this money that is being used for these meetings assist us to pay pending bills, Mr. President. People are suffering. Resources are being mobilized to do politics, to divide the people of Mount Kenya region, to fight the deputy president. When Kenyans are suffering, when we are collecting taxes from people and we are saying we don't have enough, how come millions of shillings are being mobilized across the country to fight your deputy president, to undermine his work, to divide the people of Mount Kenya region for political purposes? I think this is the lowest moment of our administration, but I am hopeful that this can be corrected and all of us can go back to work and the people of Kenya can be given an opportunity to enjoy the fruits of their vote to the president and I.
Right, and I'm sure the president will get your message. Now, what was your role in the formation of the broad-based government?
My role was very simple. Agreeing to the proposal by the president. President William Ruto sat me down and told me that he had made a decision that he needed to bring in other people so that we stabilize government and we bring everybody and we make everybody feel part of Kenya. And I was agreeable. And I told the president, if that is the intention, and to make our country move forward, improve the lives of our people, I'm agreeable. And I accepted 100%. And I support the broad-based government. I support the decision by the president. I embrace the people who joined us. And I am working well with them. And we'll continue working with them. What causes confusion is my people asking, many people asking me, how is it that the president called for broad-based government to bring in everybody so that we have one cohesive country, so that everybody is part of it, yet
About a week. And you haven't spoken to him about it?
No, I've not spoken to him about it. To be truthful, initially I thought it's a little bit. The purpose of the broad-based government. But from what the president told me, and I believed him, is that we are bringing these people so that we have one country that is cohesive and we carry everybody along. And it made sense to me.
Do you still
and I'm still persuaded that is the way to go.
Okay.
But from what I am hearing from these characters, for the meetings that they hold, and there are people very close to the president, is that the purpose of the broad-based government was to get numbers so that they can get the numbers from ODM, join the ones from Kenya Kwanza to chase Rigathi Gachagua away. If that was the intention of the broad-based government, then that would have been the deception of the highest order. And I don't think people would ever forgive the president if that was the intention.
Deputy,
you know,
president,
and I don't think, yeah. From what he has explained to me, I'm persuaded that he meant well for the country, and I'm in support of the whole thing. But if it turns out that the purpose of the broad-based government was to get numbers from ODM to join and put them together with the UDA to impeach the deputy president, then the whole broad-based government would have been a deception. It would have been a con.
Have you seen the formal agreement between the president and Raila Odinga?
No. I trust the president. and
people
many times
are planning
and many people
to remove us.
Me
how does it work?
I'm a very trusting person because when you are trusting, you trust others. You are the president gave me his word.
And if there was any written agreement
if
between
way,
these
okay.
people,
and
I
so
took
his
work
together
that to make a will to bring these people. So by the way, Sam, so trusting is regarding Gachagua and his people from the Mount Kenya region, that in the whole of this matrix, we are the only people without a written agreement with President William Ruto. We just agreed as gentlemen. I can tell you, when Musalia Mudavadi came to join President William Ruto, they have an MOU with